If there was one thing that pirates loved more than robbing, drinking, and fighting, it would have been spending time with some pleasurable company when their ships made port, and they certainly had the money to do so. With nicknames like No Conscience Nan, Buttock de Clink Jenny, and Salt Beef Peg, these women developed quite a reputation amongst pirates. Ned Ward said the following about the prostitutes of Port Royal in A Trip to Jamaica, published in 1698. A little reputation among the women goes a long way, and if their actions be answerable to their looks, they may vie in wickedness with the devil. An impudent air, being only the charms of their countenance, and a wooed carriage the studied grace of their deportment. They are such who have been scandalous in England to the utmost degree, either transported by the state, or led by their vicious inclinations to where they may be wicked without shame and whoron without punishment. Prostitution in these ports was legal, or at the very least, unenforced, and in a time where women were not allowed to work in most jobs, this allowed them to pay their bills or send money back home. In other cases, the women had been convicted of a crime and were sent away where, without family or friends, they needed to work. Other times, servant girls ran off to become prostitutes simply because they felt it offered a better life than their current situation. From their perspective, a prostitute worked shorter hours, could go drinking and dancing, and generally appeared to have more freedom than the average woman of the day. It seems most of the women preferred pirates or sailors for clients. The fact that these men had been at sea, far away from any female companions, made them desire more than just sex. These sailors wanted to spend time with the women, take them dancing, and buy them drinks and gifts. Henry Mayhew interviewed a German prostitute in his book, The London Underworld in the Victorian Period, and even though this was years after the golden age of piracy had ended, certain things didn't change. It's likely this was a common arrangement for sailors and pirates when they arrived in port. The woman said the following, "I am here tonight in this house of dancing with the sailor English, and I have known him 2 weeks. His ship is in the docks, and he will not sail from 1 month from this time that I am now speaking. I knew him before, 1 year ago and a half. He always lives with me when he come on shore. He is a nice man and give me all his money when he land always. I take all his money while he with me and not spend it quick as some of your English women do. If I not to take care, he would spend it all in 1 week. Sailor boy always spend money like rainwater. He throw it into the street and not care to pick it up again. Leave it for crossing sweeper or errand boy who passed that way. I give him a little when he want it. He know me well and have great deal confidence in me. I am honest, and he feel he can trust me. Suppose he have 24 pounds when he leave his ship, and he stay 6 weeks on land. He will spend with me 15 or 20, and he will give me what left when he leave me. And we amuse ourselves and keep both ourselves with the rest. It very bad for sailor to keep his money himself. He will fall into bad hands. He will go to ready-made outfitter or slop seller, who will sell him clothes dreadful dear and ruin him. I know very many sailors, 6, 8, 10, oh, more than that. They are my husbands. I am not married, of course not, but they think me their wife while they are on shore. Back in London, it was big news when the pirates took over Nassau, so it's no surprise that some of the prostitutes working around Corlear's Hook, which is likely where the name Hooker originated, would have traveled to the New World for better pay as well as for adventure. The women set up shop in Nassau, building homes from old sails, driftwood, and pieces salvaged from shipwrecks. It wouldn't have been out of the realm of possibilities for a pirate to marry one of these girls, since she already would have known about his secret past, a past that had a death penalty crime attached to it. If this is your first time here, I'd like to welcome you aboard. I apologize for the lack of recent videos, but I've been busy with the new business lately. I will do my best to continue to produce content on a timely scale. If you're enjoying these videos, please take a moment to like them, subscribe, and hit that bell so you always receive new notifications. And as always, if you have an idea or just want to say hello, you can leave us a comment below.